goes 220 miles an hour.
It's environmentally friendly.
It's the most energy efficient way to get people from point A to point B.
And a full-scale model is zipping through the Sunshine State.
Siemens is bringing the Velaro train to Florida to show the citizens what they will be experiencing with high-speed rail throughout the state in just a few years.
High-speed rail is already a way of life throughout Europe and Asia, and Florida is set to make transportation history as the first U.S. state to build a high-speed rail corridor. The plan? Trains will initially connect Tampa to Orlando, then in a later phase to Miami.
Florida is leading the charge for high-speed rail in the United States, and this is critical because it will provide Americans a better way to get around. It's also going to bring a lot of economic development and jobs.
Siemens will be a part of a consortium that will design, build, operate, and maintain that system.
Florida is one of several major corridors gearing up for high-speed rail in the U.S. Among the others, California, where voters backed a plan to build a 220-mile-per-hour high-speed rail line to connect northern, central, and southern California. And in the Midwest, the plan is to expand the Chicago hub network and connect the Windy City with St. Louis and Kansas City.
A modern economy needs a modern transportation system. Ground-based high-speed trains are a modern transportation system. They fit into a congested infrastructure without adding more burden to the infrastructure, and they allow for the movement of goods fast and efficient and environmentally friendly.
High-speed rail is part of an integrated and comprehensive transportation network. It's essentially the backbone. So you can hop on the high-speed train in one city, get off in the next city over, or even a couple of cities over, and from there you can get on a commuter rail line, light rail, or even a bus.
The Florida corridor is expected to cost a combined $2.7 billion in government and private funding.
High-speed rail is an investment into the future. We are competing against other global mega cities and countries in the world for being an attractive provider of goods and services, being a city where people love to move to and love to work. And for that, we need the investment in order to make these cities more competitive.
Siemens Future of Florida high-speed rail tour is stopping in cities like Tampa, Orlando, Miami, Lakeland, and Tallahassee. Floridians, meantime, can expect to hop aboard the real deal in 2015.
Thanks for watching The Auto Channel. For more great automotive information and entertainment, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.